people. Que pasa, sa, pase, what they do. Now, people, this thing is called It Happened Once Again, It Happened One More Again. We are speaking about Atta School, we are speaking about Rose Hall High School, we are speaking about Green Island, we are speaking about Hanover. And it is said that a bus driver was slapped away as he came out of his bus. As he was doing his daily routine and rolled up or pulled up into the school and stepped out of the bus, two men on a bike slapped him away. He was hit multiple times and people, it had the whole school scrambling. We are talking about teacher, we are talking about principal, we are talking about picnic, we are talking about vendor. Everybody basically grab up them foot in them hand and try to take for themselves. Now people, if we realize this seems like a reoccurring theme in a Jamaica, and it seems like these persons we are speaking about, these new millennials, they are indiscriminate. They have no regards for anybody. We are talking about all people. We are talking about people. We are talking about students. We are talking about church. We are talking about school. They will take you out just about anywhere, point blank and period. So now people, what makes this even more disturbing is that we also see said teacher rush student, parent rush teacher, parent rush student, rete, lele, blue, blah, bling, every sort of combination imaginable. And people, we see that it seems like Jamaica is getting crazy. Jamaica is getting loco. Jamaica is losing its mind. There is no more morals or ethic as it pertains to nothing, nothing at all. Point blank and period. Now people, like I said before, this is just a next perfect example, a disturbing example, because based on what we see, it is obvious that they trailed this person. It is obvious that more than likely they knew or they know where he lives. However, them like the spotlight, them like the highlight, them like for be in the news. So just based on their actions and based on this disturbing trend, it seems like these new shatter, they are going for the over-sensationalization. It seems as if they want to make the news. It seems as if they are trying to outdo each other as it pertains to stupidity and cowardness, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like I say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up. Now, before I move to the next part of my video, please subscribe to my next channel. It is called Jamaica Dancehall Source. One word. Don't put no space between the words. Now the next part of this video is called Popo acting up once again, one more again. The Popo are acting badly. Now people, we know that there is a disconnect as it pertains to the Popo and persons from the garrison. It seems as if there is a lack of respect. We are talking about respect for the Popo, and we are also speaking about, we are speaking in general. It seems like the Popo don't respect persons from the garrison. It seems as if the Popo don't respect poor people, because we see that there's a difference in their treatment as it pertains to persons from uptown. We are talking about the persons that live in a some high society versus their treatment to the persons that are poor. We are talking about in a Tivoli, we are talking about Rima, Rete, Lele, Blue, Blah, Bling. And people, this video is a next perfect example. So take a listen, take a look, and then I'll give my piece. Now people, don't get it twisted, don't get it misconstrued. The Popo in Jamaica work under extreme condition. The Popo have to face and deal with a lot of persons that are uneducated and dark. However, as a professional, you have to treat each case individually. So therefore, you have to analyze the situation. You cannot just treat everything with one or paint everything with one broad brush. And people, we see that that is what they've been doing over the past few years, the past few decades. They are not very professional. So people, that is the problem. Problem number one, problem numero uno. They have no professionalism. Now, in this case, like me say, we cannot just look at something, a little video, a little 15-minute video, and basically analyze the whole situation, because sometimes what we hear is taken out of context. Therefore, I don't know what happened that initiated or motivated him or them to act the way that they were acting. So therefore, me can't say so. However, based on what I saw in this video, it is lack of professionalism. It showed that they have a blatant disrespect or disregard for persons that are living in the garrison. It shows that these popo, them need training. It shows that these popo, they have some problem. They have an aggression problem. It seems as if they have an attitude problem. It seems as if they have an anger management problem. And people, this was displayed clearly once again. And what is even more disturbing is that when they do what they do, and these videos are on social media, we are talking about for the security minister, we are talking about for the justice minister, we are talking about the commissioner of Popo. It seems as if they don't take any action. It seems as if they are always backing up their own Popo. So people, my point is this, it seems like these popo, them have immunity. It seems as if they are always going to get the backing of their superior, irregardless of what they do or regardless of what they do. So people, that is a very bad precedent to set, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up. So the next thing that is popping in the news is that we see that one of Jamaica most wanted. We are speaking about a man that was charged for slap away, wounding with intent, and also illegal possession of a firearm. We are speaking about a person whose name is Audley Doval. Now, based on Popo information, it is said that he was on the wanted man list we are speaking about back in 2017 for a slap away. And it was said that he was acquitted. We are speaking about yesterday in front of Justice Lana Williams. We are speaking about at the Home Circuit Court. Some people, we are speaking about a next dangerous person that is coming on the road, that will be free, that can do whatever he so choose. Now, based on the court documents, it is said that his lawyer, we are speaking about top-notch attorney, we are speaking about Peter Champagne and Kemar Robinson, they applied for a no-case submission, and people, it was granted. And based on the court document, it is said that this man was charged for the 2016 slap away of a man, and the person name is Craig Gray, and he is from Gray's Farm. We are speaking about in Bagua. We are talking about St. Catherine. And based on what the Popo report or the court documents is saying, he basically slap away this person. Him and his cronies, they slap away this person and also took his fire piece. Now, people, like I said before, his lawyer, he has a top-notch lawyer, and he filed a no-case submission, and the judge basically granted it based on the fact that the witness we are speaking about, the sole witness in the case, one person, he was giving conflicting testimony. In one testimony, he claimed that the suspects were wearing a ski mask, and in the next testimony, he claimed that he saw their face. And he claimed that there was a bright light in the farm during the time or the act we are speaking about, the slap away date. However, the evidence on the scene and also the crime scene investigator, their testimony was conflicting. So people, we are speaking about lies. We are speaking about conflicting testimony, and people, that is always going to be grounds for dismissal. That is always going to be grounds for get any sort of case thrown out. So people, we see that this man is lucky more than he is innocent. So people, the moral of the story is this. We see that Jamaica is flawed as it pertains to the justice system, as it pertains to witnesses. We see that a lot of these witnesses, they are coward, they are afraid for their life because them can't trust the popo. So whenever they come to court, it is as if they get bummy. It is as if they're always talking all sorts of rubbish on people. If you are inconsistent in court, it is going to be deemed as controversial, it is going to be deemed as conflicting. So people, in this case, we see that this happened once again, one more again, point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Bless up.